most exciting global martial arts event, ONE Championship!
Memories was a year ago in Yangon, Myanmar, where we decided to throw a world title fight in Myanmar because the country of 54 million people had never had a world champion in any sport. So we said, let's bring our undefeated Russian world champion, Vitaly Big Dash, 6'4", 220 pounds, looked like The Rock. And we said, let's bring him to Yangon and let's find a local Myanmar hero. And let's put on a Rocky match of the century. The odds makers had the fight 100-1 in favor for the Russian. I'd never seen anything so crazy that entire week, full of frenzy, thousands of fans came out. It was something I just unbelievable, like out of the movies. And when the fight began, the entire stadium erupted, thousands of people chanting and screaming. The entire country watching on TV live. The first 3 minutes, the Russian bear comes out and puts the pressure on and looks like, it's going to be an easy night. Then suddenly, the Myanmar hero steps down and throws a big overhand right, drops the Russian. The stadium erupts, our TV rings, our social media metrics explode. And we think the fight's going to be over, and I can't even believe that this fairy tale, the Cinderella fairy tale, was going to happen. But no, it ended up being an all-out war, back and forth for the entire fight. But in the end, a new world champion was crowned, 100-1 underdog. This photo is now the greatest photo in the history of Myanmar sports. When Ong La won, he dropped to his knees. He wept like a child. And you had goosebumps. It was just insane. He grabbed the mic and he says to the whole country watching live, to the stadium, Myanmar, Myanmar, I'm not strong. I'm not fast, I'm not talented, but with you, I have strength, I have courage, I have what it takes to win a world champion. I am your world champion, Myanmar. We put out a video of that speech, 80,000 shares, 5 million views in minutes. The entire country celebrating their hero for the first time on the global stage, a world champion of any sport. I held a company meeting when I came back with my team. And I said, guys, the world witnessed greatness that night. But what the world didn't see were the millions of kids all over the country of Myanmar who suddenly had a belief ignite in their soul, who suddenly believed that I can do anything too, that any dream was possible because they had a world champion for the first time. And I said to my team, watch, 5 years, 10 years, 15 years from now, there will be a famous neurosurgeon from Harvard Medical And he will say, I lived in a poor village in poverty, and I saw this one amazing fight when I was 17 years old in Myanmar. And at that moment, I decided I want to be the world's greatest doctor. You see, this is one championship. It's about igniting the world with hope, strength, dreams, and inspiration. This is the power of one championship. It's not about fighting. It's not about violence. It's not about martial arts. It's about humanity. Because of these amazing stories and these values and our heroes, we've become the world's fastest growing sports property in the history, in full stop. Just a few years ago, we had 300,000 video views online. This year, we're expected to cross 4 billion, and the next couple years, 40 billion. We've gone from literally just a few countries to now 138 countries in the world, going to 194 in the next 3 years. Another snapshot is F1, started in 1950. We started 7 years ago, and we're neck and neck in terms of size as an asset, as a media property. 24 events versus 21 events, 138 countries versus 194 countries, and the list goes on. And we just crossed 10 million fans on Facebook yesterday. When I started one championship 7 years ago, I had a very simple thesis, and I thought it would be really easy. I said, look, every region of the world has several multi-billion dollar sports media properties. So if you go to America, NFL, Major League Baseball, NBA, and they're all worth $75 billion, $39 billion, and $37 billion apiece in terms of market value. You go to Europe, it's the same thing. F1, EPL, Champions League, Bundesliga, La Liga, same thing, worth tens of billions. You come to Asia, at the time, there was literally nothing. Nothing on a Pan-Asian basis, except for cricket in India, a $5 billion property, IPL, baseball in Japan, soccer in China, but there was nothing on a Pan-Asian basis. But yet, Asia's been the home of martial arts for 5,000 years. There's a martial art in every single country that is part of the history, the fabric of society, culture, tradition. And so when I saw these numbers, I'm like, man, U.S. has a $20 trillion economy. Asia has a $23 trillion economy. The U.S. has a population of 325 million people. Asia has a population of 4 billion people. U.S. has an ad market as a proxy for revenues, potential revenues for just one revenue stream for sports properties, ad market of $200 billion. Asia had $165 billion, growing double digits, and it would overtake the U.S. market. So I said, man, there must be a way to unite 4 billion people to celebrate Asia's greatest cultural treasure, Asian values of integrity, humility, honor, respect, courage, discipline, compassion, Asian heroes on the global stage, the best martial artists on the planet, and their stories. Today, there are three properties that are in the billion-dollar range in Asia. CSL in China, IPL in India, and one championship. But only one championship has the ability to scale and unite 4 billion people. And my goal is to be the number one sports media property in the world, overtaking NFL in the future. Thank you. Thank you. At the end of the day, for me, like, this has been a crazy journey. I don't want to make it sound like it was easy. So I made it look sound easy right now, but the first 3 years, it's a seven-year-old company. The first 3 years, I got rejected thousands of times. I failed 1,000 times every day, every week, every month. Everyone said, that's stupid. Why would Asia want a sports property? We already have NBA on TV, F1, EPL. We don't need sports. Every broadcaster refused to air the content. No advertisers, no sponsors, no government, and even employees didn't even want to join me. It was living hell for 3 years. And actually, I remember after 3 years of failing and failing, and the business was going nowhere, zero, burning cash. We lost $50 million, and the business had nothing. And I picked up the phone. I remember I called my mom, who's this conservative Japanese lady, and she had told me before I started One Championship, don't start it. It's a stupid idea. It's a dumb business. Who gives a shit about martial arts? I called her, my mom. Man, it's really hard. It's harder than I thought. And my mom said, you see, I told you so. And of course, it broke my heart. But then she said, Chatri, it's easy. Why don't you just quit? I thought for a split second about quitting. I hung up the phone. Why don't you just quit? Martial arts has been my greatest passion in life. I'm a martial artist for 34 years. I train every single day. Even until now, I train every day. Just trained last night. Every single day. I feel the Western properties have misrepresented martial arts and have created a blood sport, violence, a spectacle of hatred and anger and controversy. People who beat up their wives can go on pay-per-view and beat up people who break up buses are felons and can go in and celebrate as heroes. Those aren't heroes to me. A hero is somebody who espouses incredible values that can serve as a hope, as an inspiration, as a role model to children. So my definition of success is if children all over Asia put up the posters of my heroes, of our heroes, I want the parents to be like, that's amazing. Not because they want their children to be professional fighters, but because that person has these amazing values, lived an incredible life story, and achieved and unleashed their greatness. You see, I don't believe that any of us was put here on this earth just to have a job, just to get a mortgage, just to pay bills, just to buy a car. No, I believe that all of us were put on this earth to unleash our greatness in life so that we can give back more than we receive. Because at the end of the day, we are one. Thank you.